Ciao a tutti, welcome to another video. So today we're gonna start a new journal. This is a journal that I got from a package with the planner. And these are different sizes. It's basically a square, let's say, if you open the two pages. So we are gonna do a strange page in this one. I want to have this journal dedicated to Disney, or kind of Disney inspired, let's say. And this page is inspired by Raya the Last Dragon. That this is one of the latest Disney movie, and my son is really obsessed with it. This one and another one, but we will see later. So how to start this page? I'm thinking to divide the page in three sections, and we have the section on the top left corner in blue, and I'm just mixing the acrylic paint that I have. This is cobalt blue and pale blue. I'm not mixing precisely, so as always I want to see some strokes, so that's what I'm doing now. Then on the right bottom corner, I'm gonna put some orange brown, let's say, and I'm using three colors. I'm using yellow ochre, I'm using burnt sienna, and another ochre color. And then again, I'm mixing there with not a lot of attention about strokes and everything, as always. And then the last corner, we are gonna have what color is this? Flesh, that is a kind of vanilla or light pink, and some white. So those are the three base color of the page, and the reason why I'm choosing those three colors is because the blue to me indicate Sisu, then the orange brown indicate Raya, and the other one indicate Namari. So basically the three major character of the movie, so the three girls of the movie. And I will then go with some doodling on top of that, again inspired by the movie. I'm then trying to blend a little bit, let's say, the three section, and I'm doing a little bit with the brush, but mainly then I'm gonna use a sponge and dab a little bit of color. So I will on the lighter section I'm gonna use mainly the white, and then in between the blue and the yellow I'm gonna put some light blue on top of the yellow, and some yellow on top of the blue, kind of mixing, let's say. So it's gonna fade one into each other, or at least that's the idea basically. And for Raya I choose the yellow and brown because for majority of the movie she has those colors, even if in the beginning she has mainly blue and violet, and it's more in line with the place from where she's coming from. But I don't know why they changed, to be honest, I don't know why they changed the color to her color during all the rest of the movie. But I prefer, to be honest, the first outfit. But anyway, so let's move on. Now this part is about the doodling, so that will be basically the whole focal point of the page. And I'm basically, so in the end of the movie there were some how is it called in English? Titoli di coda. Wait a minute. I look into Google. Google Translate helped me every time. So the credits. Okay, that's the titoli di coda in English. And basically on that section, and also when in the beginning of the movie, when there is Kumandra described, there are a lot of doodling idea, and that's where I was inspired for the focal point. So I'm doing some clouds, I'm doing of course the sphere, the magic sphere, and the drop, the raining drops, and then some mountains, stylistic mountains, not really, but mountains anyway, and then also some bush and forest, let's say, something like that. Again, there are a lot of this, I really like the style of those doodling when I saw the movie, and that's why I decided to do this page, because I wanted to replicate basically this style. I'm using the marker that I have on my stage, but the only common point is to use the gold. This is my acrylic marker in water-based and in gold. This is great for this page, basically. It saved me. And then, so that's what I'm doing, all the doodling, mixing colors, etc. About the movie, first of all, have you seen the movie? I saw it, of course, as I told you, a lot of time with my son that is obsessed about the dragon. But I have to say, I like the movies, not so bad, but maybe for an adult I was expecting a bit more, because I think something is missing on this movie, to be honest. If I have to think about what, I think it's too much in focus on Raya and a little bit less on Sisu, but what is missing is basically Namari. Sometimes Namari, I don't understand why Namari is doing those stuff, why she's chasing in the beginning, why she's obsessed with Raya. There's no explanation about that, to be honest. Okay, let's say I don't want to ruin anything if you didn't see the movie, but it's nice to see, but for an adult I think something is missing there. But okay, anyway, the movie is nice, and of course my son is obsessed about the dragons. The last part of the movie is about all those colorful and fluffy dragon flying in the sky, coming from the water, and that's what obsessed my son, basically, and I think a lot of kids. Then, what else? After doing those doodling, I'm gonna cut everything, glue everything on the page as always, and I'm gonna do also the quote. The quote is pretty basic. I didn't know exactly what to put in there, so I just draw the words trust, because basically that's the major word. If I have to describe the movie in one word, this is the word, basically. It's about trust. And also this one, maybe then, for an adult, this one, okay, I mean, it's fine, but the unconditional trust to everybody, okay, I mean, it's positive, a positive message, but still, I think I'm a person that you need to know someone before give completely your trust to the person, but okay, that's the message of the movie. Anyway, so that's basically the page. I'm then gonna add some doodling to frame the page. I'm gonna do a border. I'm using first a light yellow marker, but it was too light, so it was not visible a lot on the page, so then I decided to use the golden directly and do the doodle inspired again about the movie. And so it's just a straight two line, a parallel line with some dots, and then the water, because that's the main picture, let's say, of the movie. And finally, I'm gonna add some highlights with my Posca pen. So in the end it was fun and nice, because I really wanted to do those doodling, And I hope that this journal will have much more Disney Spider movie. We'll see the next one. So give me a thumbs up if you like it and you got inspired, but most importantly, if you saw the movie, just leave me a comment below. Let me know if you like it or if you think like me that something is missing. Okay, anyway, that's it for the page. I'm gonna leave some close-up picture in the end. As always, thank you so much for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.